Hey, sir.
Yeah, hi.
You have your license on you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No problem. What's the problem?
Huh?
What's the problem?
You have a headlight out.
Oh. Okay, I'm sorry about that.
Okay.
Okay. No problem other than that. There's my license.
Okay, this is your current address on
counter
form?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where you coming from tonight?
What's that?
Where you coming from tonight?
I've just been working hard and that's it.
Okay. Have anything to drink tonight?
No.
Nothing to drink?
Nothing.
Okay. I see because I smell something in the vehicle. No? You have an ID on you?
Well. So I'm sorry about the headlight.
Okay. Things happen. Sit back here with me, sir.
What's that?
Want to sit back here?
Out the car?
Yes.
Yeah. Where are we going?
Just right here.
Okay.
Step back here.
I am. I'm going with you.
Okay. Well, ask you again. Have you had anything to drink tonight?
No.
Okay. I smell it in the vehicle.
What's that?
I smell it in the vehicle.
There's nothing in the vehicle.
Do you have a hearing aid or?
No, I do not.
Okay.
No.
Double check it. Okay. What I'm going to do is run you through field sobriety test, check your ability to drive. Okay, is everything checked out all right? Let you go. Like I said, the reason I stopped you now is because of the headlight, okay?
I'm sorry about the headlight. I mean...
Well, it doesn't matter. It's all right. Things happen. I mean, lights go out. It happens.
I'm a lawyer in Cincinnati.
Okay.
I understand that.
Okay.
But, you know, I'll pay the headlight for my ticket.
Well, I'm not going to write you a ticket tonight for it.
Okay.
It's just worth a warning, okay?
Okay. Okay. Fine. Okay. Then we can go.
Okay. Why don't you just step over here out of the light?
All right.
So it doesn't affect your eyes or anything?
All right.
Okay. So put your arms down by your side? Okay, just follow my finger with your eyes and eyes only, okay?
Yes.
Then follow my finger with your eyes and eyes only.
Sure.
Don't move your head. You're moving your head.
What?
Just your eyes. That's all
okay.
I need. You're moving your head, bud.
Well, I know, but it's... Okay.
Okay. Where are you lawyer at?
Cincinnati, Ohio.
Cincinnati. Okay. You're in a whole other state, okay?
I know.
Okay.
I know.
All right.
I'm true.
Okay. Again, follow my finger with your eyes only, don't move your head.
Okay. Right there.
Are you going to do the test or not?
Well, I did. That guy just came here, though. That's all.
I don't care about the guy.
Okay, I know.
Okay. Your eyes are like marbles in your head.
My eyes are...
Okay.
You good?
Well, got a couple more tests to show. To do
right.
For you, okay?
Well,
how are your legs and everything?
What do you mean?
How are your legs? As far as walking, bouncing, stuff like that?
I've had some knee injuries lately, but other
okay.
than that, I'm okay.
Okay, what you got in your mouth? Chewing gum? Okay, why don't you go spit that out? Okay. Let's see. Come back over here.
All right.
Okay, which leg would you say would be the best?
What, to stand on?
Yeah.
Oh, gee. Probably my right leg.
Okay.
No, my left leg would be better, I think.
Okay. Like I said, any leg you want, raise it 6 inches off the ground. When I tell you to do so, 6 inches off the ground, toe pointing up. You're going to count 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, just like that. Tell you to stop, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Hang on.
So what do you want me to do? You want me to do this. Okay.
Yeah, when I tell you to begin, you're going to raise your foot 6 inches off the ground, toe pointed out. You're going to hold that position. You're going to count 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, just like that. Tell you to stop.
That's pretty hard to do.
I know. Just try to do the best you can do.
Okay. So are we okay so far, though?
Well, I don't know. You wouldn't do the test right.
What?
You wouldn't do the test right with my finger, so.
I tried to. Did I not do it right?
Well, you started turning your head a couple times.
No, but after that, I did it okay, right?
Oh, not really. Your eyes were just moving back and forth. You wouldn't follow my finger or anything. All right, so I'm just going to move on to the next test. All right.
All right. So did I fail that one?
Technically, yeah.
Oh, gee.
Yeah. There's no other way to put it. So we're going to go for this test here, see how we do here.
So, wait a sec. Am I okay or not okay?
Oh, no, I smell alcohol in your breath.
No.
No?
No. No alcohol.
Okay, let's how about we just do this and disprove it? Would you take a portable breath test right now and disprove it?
I will not.
Okay, then we're going to go forward with the test. If not, it's going to be considered a refusal. Are you going to refuse my test?
No, I don't want to refuse your
Okay, test. Then let's just go and continue on with what we're going to do.
But, you know, if you're not... All right, let's go.
Okay. Either way you want, like I said, you're going to raise the 6 inches off the ground, toe pointed out. You're going to count 1,001, 1,002, 1,003.
On
like I'm doing right here. Okay. Hold on a second. It's going to be timed. Hang on. You're holding on to the vehicle. You got to come away from the vehicle. Hey, sir?
Yeah.
Come over here. Away from the vehicle. I told you when I begin. When I tell you to begin. Okay. Are you ready to begin?
Yeah.
Okay, begin. You gotta get your hand off the vehicle.
Okay.
You're not completed yet.
Well, I'm on a hill here, too.
I just held the position right here.
But you're...
I got 20 pounds of extra weight around my waist.
I got 22.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay. We're going to do another test, okay? Let's start over here. All right, facing that way.
Yeah.
Put your right foot in front of your left foot, touching heel to toe, just like that. Okay, hold that position. When I tell you to begin, go ahead and hold that position. Okay, when I tell you to begin, you're going to take 9 heel toe steps, just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 9. That being your 9th step, you're going to take a pivot turn, just like this. Come back to heel to toe.
Like this?
Well, you're supposed to walk straight, bud.
Toward you?
Okay. Okay, stop. All right, step back over here away from me. Okay, I'm going to read you something, okay? Are you going to take a portable breath test?
No.
Okay. I have probable cause to believe you operated a vehicle while intoxicated. Refusal to submit to a chemical test results in suspension 1 year of your driver's license, okay, for refusing the test. If you have a previous conviction for operating while intoxicated, your refusal to submit to my chemical test results in suspension for 2 years. Will you take the certified test?
No.
Okay. Just turn around, put your hands behind your back.
What am I doing?
You're being placed under arrest for DUI.
Why?
Refusal. Because you're clearly intoxicated. You can't do none of the tests right. You're giving me problems. I can smell the alcohol in the breath.
I'm not trying to give you a problem.
We are. I don't care if you're a lawyer or not. This isn't Ohio. This is Indiana. We do things a little bit different here. Okay? That's a problem I always run into with people from Ohio. They don't think they have to do an officer's test.
I'm very sorry.
Okay. Well, you're not sorry because you're not doing my test. You understand the job I have to perform.
I'm trying to do your job. I really am.
You're not doing my job, you're not doing my test.
I'm trying to. I swear I am trying to do your test.
Okay, but you did none of them right, even after several times being explained to.
Can I do this?
No, I did the three tests. I offered you a portable breath test. You refused that.
Yeah, but...
I offered you a certified test, like I just read to you. You're refusing that, I guess.
I don't know what a certified test is.
You go down to a sheriff's department, blow into a breathalyzer. If you pass, catch or lose.
What's your test here? What's the...
It's a data master. You blow into a machine.
Yeah.
And whatever... they raise it in alcohol above a .08, then it's DUI.
And then what happens?
Then you're placed under arrest for DUI. Now, if you refuse that test, it's going to be refusal. I'm going to take you to the sheriff's department, place you in there. I'm going to get a search warrant for your blood. I'm going to get your blood. And then you still go to jail. Okay? Good. See that red dot in there?
My timing was good.
The red dot right there. Everything's been recorded and also on audio tonight. So I have documented evidence of what's going on here tonight.
I know.
Okay.
My driving was good then.
I didn't stop you based on your drive. I stopped you based on your headlight.
Well, my headlight was...
Your headlight's out.
No.
One of your headlights is out.
That's very weak. I mean...
It doesn't matter. To stop, stop. Okay. Go turn around. Are you going to take the test, first of all?
So what is Indiana, though? What happened? So?
I just told you what happened.
Could you repeat it?
Like I just read to you, I have probable cause to believe you operated a vehicle while intoxicated.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I must now offer you the opportunity to submit to a chemical test. Your refusal to submit to that chemical test, which is the breathalyzer, results in suspension of your driving privileges for 1 year. If you have a previous conviction, means you've been arrested before for OWI,
no.
Your refusal to submit to my test results suspension for 2 years. Will you take that test?
2 year suspension.
If you have a prior, it's 1 year if you don't.
I have no prior.
The refusal will be 1 year suspension.
And
you go to jail.
Okay, but the test does what?
The test tells me whether you're intoxicated or not.
And if it's over 08, what happens?
You go to jail.
And then what happens?
Then you go see the judge. You're a lawyer. You know how this works.
Well, every district is different.
Well, I mean, it's pretty obvious you go to jail for DUI.
And not overnight, necessarily.
You'll stay in probably the weekend unless they give you a bond. So are you going to take the test or not?
Well, in Ohio...
I don't care about Ohio. We're not in Ohio anymore. Okay. Are you going to take the test or not?
Hang on just a second.
No. Yeah, it's a yes or a no.
Let me think it's a
second. No, it's a yes or a no.
Can I call a lawyer?
Nope. You don't get a lawyer at this junction.
Either way, I get arrested?
If you refuse, yeah.
If I test?
If you test and you pass, you go home. You fail, you stay in jail for DUI.
And
that's it.
So either way, I'm arrested.
Unless you pass.
So, if it's a refusal, though, I mean, don't you just release you?
No. No refusal, I get one for blood and you still go to jail.
Can I try the test again?
No, we already did the test. Okay. I explained each test several times.
So what level, I mean, is there a level above 08?
0.08 or above. You're considered OWI.
And then what happens to me?
Turn around, put your hands behind your back.
What happens to me on that?
Turn around, put your hands behind your back.
Okay.
Release your hands. Release your hands.
Okay.
We can get these cuffs on easily, or...
I'm sorry. What about my car?
I'm going to pound it. For sale, 4224. That was a 1055 being the lot of the
Where's my cargo?
Be at Burger King in Greendale, US 50 in Lori Lane. Have a one in custody for refusal. I have a 2 1027. Who's she?
The girl I met.
27 on white male through Ohio, last name Mecklenborg. Mecklenborg. First name Robert, Robert. No initial P, Paul. Robert P. Mecklenborg. DOB of 1952-41. 1952-41, white male Ohio break. It's 29 on white female through Kentucky, last name Roberts, R-O-B-E-R-T-S. First name Tonya, T-I-O-N-A, middle initial N, Nora. DOB of 1985-130. Okay, come on back here. Come on.
I am. Now she... Well, she can get out of the car, right?
She can go wherever she wants to.
Well, give her a license back and let her go.
Well, when I find out she's not wanted or something, I will. Have a seat.
Right here?
Yes, sir. Have a seat.
Can you take these off?
Nope. Get in the car.
Okay. Ow. Can I take these off? So she can leave immediately, right?
I'm gonna find out she has no warrant on her.
Yeah. Can I take these off?
No. Miss?